Hello, everyone. How's it going? I can't speak. My voice is gone. Hey, Kaz. Hey, Beijo. Spin-a-mo. I like it. I like it so much. It's so cute. Right. Hello, Aclaria.
Yes, hello, Amber. I
Hello.
went and grabbed ice cream, so.
Oh, did you get me some?
Love to.
Send it over to Ireland. It'll be melted by the time it gets here, but I mean the thought counts.
The
Actually, you know what? You've now that you've mentioned it, it is kind of warm in my room, so I'm just gonna open my window a little bit.
Yeah.
It's starting to get warmer now. I'm noting it more and more, like it's no longer cold. I'm just waiting for the heat to start kicking in, like fully, right? Because I know it's gonna happen. It's nice now, but like, oh my God, it's gonna get like ridiculously hot soon. In a
Be
couple of
my
weeks,
feet what
in
well
a couple of weeks, it might be unbearable.
it might be yeah
Yeah, I mean, I'm gonna be lumping my fan behind me soon. I'm gonna have to, because once the heat starts kicking in, I cannot live in
yeah
this room. My room is at the front of the house, so I get the most heat. The front,
oh
so
no
yeah. So I gotta get that in my room stat. I don't need it on at the moment, but I mean I need it in my room so that like as soon as like it gets really hot, I can turn it on and just have a like nice cool breeze hitting at my back, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Anyway, I'm getting off topic. How about we get back on topic and we do things? So you're ready to go for the near reads, right?
Yes. The
So
comment section has been unlocked.
we just need to spend time and wait for other people online to get online. So
Yeah.
let's abandon the children and go to Charlea. Bye, kids.
Like it's we are giving you the Ashara training.
No, the Ashara treatment would be inviting them into the party,
Specifically.
teleporting them to the Golden Saucer, then like leaving, kicking them from the party, and then teleporting away. That's the Ashara treatment. You should
Very
know it
accurate.
happened to you.
Do not
Specifically.
remind me. Bra went over to Netherlands without picking me up. How dare.
I see how it is. Don't worry. You'll be fine. You're old enough to take care of yourselves. Right. So, Tartaru. Shall we see what she has for us?
Yeah.
She's gonna work us like slaves.
Look, it's Tartaru. At this point, I expected it.
So when I click on this person, she has two quests for me. Does she also have two quests for you?
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll go with Soaring Prophets first.
All right.
I don't know if that's the order we go in, but I'm going with
I
top
do
to
believe so.
bottom. Okay, so I'll be Majinga? Is that how you say her name?
Medina, I think, yeah.
I'll do her. Why, hello there! Your arrival could not have been more timely. Mistress Tataru has just left instructions for another batch of deliveries. She sends her regards, of course. Today she is in Idleshire for business with Winona's House of Splendors, and tomorrow will no doubt find her in some other far-flung corner of the realm. We mustn't be outdone, Amber and Eclaria. This time, our samples are destined to two organizations in Corthus, an arrangement made possible by none other than Master Sigrid. He contacted his dear friend, Lord Emanuelin de Fortems, on the buddies! The besties! Yeah, so I love that these two are besties, though. It's so funny because they're complete opposites.
They keep bickering, it's amazing.
They're like an old married couple who was kind enough to spread the word of the boutique to his own contacts across Ishgard. Okay. Amandalan being helpful. It's hardly took any time for the first letter of interest to reach us. And once these samples have been delivered, that interest will be piqued to a passion. Passion? Passion. I don't know why I'm saying that passion. Anyway, or so I'd been assured by Lord Manel. Oh god. Endurances by this dude are to be taken with a giant pinch of salt, right? take a giant salt and that's how much of a pinch you need to be taking, right? Has insisted he will take care of all the particulars and bid me convey with enthusiasm that he looks forward to accompanying you on the deliveries. Oh no.
Oh no.
I love that my warrior of light is not sighing at disbelief because, like, this guy is not
prepared.
Look.
Yeah, just prepared.
We're just babysitting a big boy.
Yeah.
Now then, regarding the secret mission of ours. The glorious sapphire is a glorious sapphire, is it not?
A gorgeous.
I can't read it, Glaria. It will make a beautiful. It will make a beautiful necklace once restored. A keepsake for not only Mistress Tataro's mother, but that of her many friends and allies across the realm. I am confident that someone of your expertise has the most discerning eye for mementos. Bring back anything you think will make a worthy addition. Okay. We can do that, can't we, Eclaria? We have eyes for...
No, we have eyes.
We have eyes.
Mm-hmm.
And with that, I will leave these samples in your capable hands and eagerly await your safe return. Right? Onwards. We are delivery person. We go from Savior of Eorzea to conqueror of the stars to delivery person very fast. Shall we pick up the second one as well, or shall we wait until we return to pick it up?
If they are... Okay, I think we can pick them up. I think. Just because if it's like a separate quest in itself, I don't think it's like a story continuous quest anyway then. Because it is separate. We might as well just pick it up.
Is it separate?
Yeah.
It has a... Okay, so it's not part of Tartar's Grand Endeavors?
I think it is, but each of them is like, it has its own separate plot. Like, it's one, like, similar theme, but it's just like, separate location, so I don't think it's like a chain quest.
Look, we'll wait until we get back. How's that sound? We have to report back to her anyway, so...
Yeah.
It makes more sense to do the thing, and you are teleporting us to Ishgard. Thank you.
Welcome.
Do you think we'll see our boy?
Our boy? No.
Do you think he'd be too busy to make an appearance? I think he always makes time for us, though. Specifically because we are the Warrior of Light.
Hey,
Bonnie. Well, I'm here. Where are you?
I'm coming.
Whee!
I am sorry, I'm like casually jumping down.
It's just casually jumping to her death.
Mm-hmm.
Waiting. Oh!
Oh!
Oh boy.
Oh, hello.
I do not look forward to babysitting you, please. Do you want to be a Manolin?
Sure. Ember, Eclaria, oh girl. Tis good to see a rosy glow in your cheeks, considering
why is he calling me old?
I love that nickname. The dreadful business with the imminent destruction of mankind and the end of times and whatnot.
Oh, Jesus.
Yes, indeed. Who better to distribute exquisite arms and contraband than a bona fide hero such as yourself? Well, I have two parties with simply ravenous interest in your product, dear ladies. The first of whom so happens to be rather exquisite herself, my dearest lady... Lenny, I never Lenny. Okay, look, Lily. Be so good as to precede me to the Rose House. I shall be along promptly, of course.
Did you see the
just
look
as soon as I coif and powdered.
Did you see the look on our character's face before it like went to this text box? We were just like,
Sure, dear. Yeah. Yes, totally agree.
We just nod in agreement.
Yes, just nod, just smile and nod, yes.
At least she's enthusiastic, okay? He has enthusiasm. Right? Yeah. Enthusiasm. Yeah. Okay.
Very enthusiastic.
Why are you teleporting? Oh, it's in Cloudtop. Oh.
Yeah.
I thought it was somewhere else in Ishgard. Thank you. Where are you? I got out the chocobo! There we go. Oh, this place! Oh no.
Yeah, she never moves. She's always here. She avoids Ishgard like the plague because of a Manolin.
How did he get?
I don't know.
Also, Jess! Thank you for the resub. Welcome in. All of, look at those emotes. All right. Well met, Amber. Tis good. Well met, Amber and Eclaria. Tis good to see you, hale and whole.
Oh, cutscene.
And cutscene. Thank you for personally making the trip. I know your obligations are many. Not really. I have nothing to do. Truth be told, your arrival could scarce have had better timing. While our erstwhile troubled relations with the Vanu Vanu improve by the day, we have been forced to reconsider our current munitions due to recent incidents of...
Oh no,
what did he do now?
I have come, my darling Blossom. Behold Amandalane the executioner, here to smite your foes with ruthless adore. What the fuck?
Can he not behave? Can he not just behave himself? Why is it every time that we come to Ishgard and Amandalane is involved, we're always cleaning up after him? Yes, Jess, I did see your art. Thank you. It is beautiful. It is lovely. Right. What did he do? Oh my god, what the fuck? What is he wearing? It does not suit you. It does not suit you. Go back to your old look.
Go back to your old look. Look, he's trying out new style on the by the advice of his bestie, okay?
No, we have no words for this, right?
I'm really speechless. I don't know what to say. Well, I strike a rather smashing silhouette, do I not? Why, Sigurd could not have found a better man to give this sample to.
Surely such splendid armor could be put to better use than fashion, Lord Amalyn. Could I not prevail upon you to better sense to relinquish that gear to those who might appreciate its particulars?
Practicality.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. So be it for me to deny any request of yours, Lady Lynette. Only, I must confess that I may have slightly exaggerated Sikard's generosity in that matter of gifting this. He stole it, didn't he?
Ah, you mean you say you borrowed them? No doubt without his knowledge or consent? Why are you like this? Why are you like this? Why is it every time this happens, Amandalyn? Do you not learn?
He never learns.
And why should I have expected otherwise? Friends may forgive, but it bears repeating that your clients deserve at least a modicum of professionalism. Does he know what that word means?
Professionalism.
You do have other clients, don't you?
Of course I have. And of no little celebrity at that. You remember the red bills, of course.
Red bills? Do I?
The
Sky Pirates. I forgot what they were called. It's been a while since I did the Sky Pirates. I just called them the Sky Pirates.
Same.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
The Sky Pirates. They... That... That an experienced adventurer should know them hardly surprises me. But how does a privileged son of House Fortems come to make their direct acquaintance?
It was a happy coincidence of ill and circumstance, I assure you. As Emperor Nicolari here can attest, an unbiased range of social contacts is the essential arsenal of not just adventurers, but any gentleman of consequence, or lady of consequence, as it were.
You had a drink with them, basically, is what he's saying.
Yeah.
Basically, they got him drunk. He didn't get them drunk. Unbiased is all very well, but Sky Pirates are precisely the problem I was speaking of earlier, Amber, before we were interrupted. Recently, self-proclaimed Sky Pirates have been marauding trade vessels with trouble accuracy. Even the Sky Steel Manufactory has reported stolen property at the hands of these ruffians. I can go sort that out and see if it is the actual band of of the Sky Pirates that I know of. But probably not.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm gonna
say that this is all his fault. Right. Now. I'm saying this is all his fault. He said something, and then they went and did things, and it's all gonna turn out to be a Manolin made things worse.
Mm-hmm. Troubling news indeed, though I cannot imagine fellows as amicable as our Red Bills could be responsible. Still, if we should hear all of it, I shall send word directly. Now then, Amber and Nicolaria, off we trot to the infamous Parok. I have been taught to seek out a certain raid standard upon Colwyn. How the pulse quickens.
Oh boy. Can you fly? How are you getting there?
We will tie a rope around his waist and hang him off of our mount.
Mm-hmm.
And just say good luck.
And just bump into every rock.
Yes, that's how we do the Sky Pirating adventure.
Mm-hmm. I love that he runs and we walk. Oh, it teleports us here. Oh, that's so nice. Oh, before we go in, Eclaria, let's talk to him. See what he has to say.
Oh no, that's the one thing I want to avoid. This looks rather promising, wouldn't you say? I leave the rest to your uncanny sense of direction, old girls, to the Parok we go.
Oh my god. Stop calling us old!
I went and searched the meaning of that. It's just like a very like olden day nickname.
I know.
But I do not understand where it comes from. Why old?
Oh, hello, kitty cat.
Okay, so we got a few people. I'll be Leo Ford, I guess. Well, whoa! If it isn't it ain't the very picture of health. Amber, Claria, saviors of the star from complete annihilation. Don't tax you out much then, eh? The cat.
I can't with the design of this.
Let me guess. It was not. It was not compared to all the blowing and scrapping required of the Macantel
Legendel.
Oh god. What?
English, look, let's skip it.
Don't tell this dandy that is what wooed you from the life with sweet nothings of financial comfort.
Leoford, my good man, you know as well as I that the only one wooing ever declaring to anything is yourself.
I mean,
don't think you're in. I mean, he can woo. What? Wouldn't we take
Leoford over Manolin any day of the week?
Ah, yes, that's for sure. That's for sure.
Okay.
I'll stick with my Emmerich, it's fine.
I'll stick with my Graha, thank you.
Don't think your interest in our mutual friend here escaped my notice. Your aim all along was less about armament than it was an audience with these two, was it not?
That smile! Not bad for a dandy, eh? I might have had my sights on a touching reunion between Amber, Aclaria, and myself. But that's not what to say. I won't be needing those samples. See, I've a job that could write benefit the both of your keen sense and those pieces you've bought me, so long as they're half the quality of what a Madeline was showing off at the alehouses, anyway. I can count on your participation, yes? You'll be duly compensated, of course. Just name your price.
My price. Kick this bitch off.
Kick this bitch off. Parts for a necklace for Tatao Tower herself, eh?
Preferred. You really say preferred.
It should be pilfered, right?
I don't know what this is. Look, yeah, English, I'm fine.
Might make use of. Anyway, he has something. But far be it for me to dictate what woman with her booty. What? What is this?
A treasure.
This is what I don't miss from the Sky Pirates. This pirate talk. If that's your recompense, I'll see what I can do. Okay, you can be this girl.
Okay. Now that we have you on board, allow me to elaborate. It seems another band of petty thieves has been masquerading as sky pirates and harrying honest traders as of late.
Oh, we heard about that.
So you've heard of them? Aye, these so-called monstrous cockatoos don't exactly strike fear into the heart of men, but they're being a riot nuisance. And now they've gone and made things personal.
Is that what they're called?
Yeah. What a name.
Oh god. You remember the Remelin, don't you? The captain's old airship. Well, after what happened in Dunscaith, we've been commissioning the finest airship parts from across the realm for constructing of her successor. Only to have the counterparts nincompoops privileged to the very sky steel manufacturing vessel that was carrying our precious cargo. Oh, the nerve of some people, eh? Makes my mouth water.
Of course, once the cockatoos realized whose property they pilfered, they flew into a panic and holed up in Edershire after stashing their goods somewhere. This is where you and your samples come in. We want you to take Leoford and...
Before you spill the rest, Stacia?
Stacia.
Let's make sure our friend here is still up for a spot of Fowlin. How about it then? Oh god. My what? My Mercury Gentile is at your service. I have a craving for Game Bird lately. The second option?
Yeah.
I knew I was right to call you. Those downy ducklings won't know what plucked them. You can be Kitsit.
Okay. Quite so. With Ember Nuclear return and our crew complete, victory over these near duels is most certainly assured. By the by, would you have any terrible objections if I informed the Rose Knights of your designs upon these charlatans? The Knights are affiliated with House Helena, you see, and thus have particular interest in recovering the content of the Sky Steel vessel. I know my darling of the most capable Lady Lenniette simply will not rest until she has brought these scoundrels to justice.
He has a giant crush on her and she's just not interested, I think.
Yeah, she's just been gone.
Can't say it's an alliance I've ever considered, but so long as I get all the cockatoo I'm due, our knights most thornly are welcome to catch the cage as they see fit.
Splendid. Lady Lenia shall be very glad to hear of it. Overjoyed, even. Yes. She may simply be unable to contain her unbounded delight. I must away. Yeah, kick you down. Go, that's the fastest way you can.
He just jumps.
What?
I think he likes her when she's, like, mean to him.
I don't know, I think he just has this like massive crush and he just won't stop until like she show an arm.
The moment she praises him, the moment he goes, I've been praised! Life is complete, yeah. And then he dies.
Yeah.
Not awaiting us in Idleshire, but daggers and subterfuge. But such is more tempting to our ilk than lonely knights, eh? Lovely knights, eh? Let us be off. I'll explain the rest of the gambit once we get there. Oh, Kate says it's coming with us too. Nice.
Cool.
Oh, and it teleports us here. That's so nice of the game. Free TP!
Whee!
Just waiting for you to pop in. I like that you have an umbrella. It is raining. Can I hide under it?
Yeah.
Yee.
Good stuff. Okay, right. Well, we'll just talk to Linford. Get out of the rain. Who's the dandy now, you ask? I reckon my reputation precedes me in these parts. And the legendary Red Bull Leoford ain't known for hogs like these. Okay. Also, I like that as soon as I step out from the umbrella and talk to him, the rain stops.
Perfect timing.
So, I could get used to this. Comfortable, practical, and with sense of style to boot. Ain't often you find the holy triad in battle gear. Quite the line you're toting. Which brings us to your role in my master plan. Well, we ain't easy laying low in a motley place like Idletire. These cowards have been managing it well enough. So to lure them out, we're going to spread savvy rumors of a black market looking to fleece fine contraband for even finer coin. That's you.
How dare.
Just strike up a chat with any adventurers or peddlers that seem like to share hearsay. I'll be playing your handsome bodyguards. So rest assured, I've got your back, mistress. Woohoo!
Why, hello there.
We have our own personal bodyguard.
He looks good in that fit, I would just say. He looks better in this than his original outfit. I've taken the liberty of preparing your guys. It ain't as flattering as Leofert's, woman. But you should fit the part nicely in this.
Lenford is now accompanying you. Keep him at your side and continue weaving the black markets. Okay. Can do. Yes.
Okay, yes. Okay. We know. Oh, ew.
Oh my god.
What the fuck are we wearing, Ember? Hey, hold on. Come back. I'm taking a G-pose of this shit. This is very flattering. What? Why? You know, the outfit itself is terrible. But why the, why the glasses as well? Oh no. Okay.
We're merchants. Suddenly.
Alright.
Oh my god. We gotta go all over this town.
Yeah.
You Peloton? Can you, thank you.
Oh, I can. Whee!
We're in a party, so you might as well use it. Yeah. Which way did you go?
I'm here!
Cool, we're going in the same direction. Okay.
Yeah.
Approachable adventurer. Contrabands. Well, I do know of some sky pirates new into town, and just the other day I overheard them discussing their latest windfall. Ah yes, just the sort of enterprising folk we're in looking for. You think you could help us pin them down? I'll do what I can. I'm no stranger to sky pirates. So I'll ask around. Okay.
We'll just go in a circular.
Yeah. That's probably the easiest way to go about this.
Yeah.
I think it's over here. I think. Yes, I see him. I see the guy.
Yes. Hello, sir.
You can be this guy.
Okay. A merchant yourself, are you? Perhaps I'm overstepping, but consider this a friendly advice. Seeking out a sky pirate's dress in such stereotypical garb is akin to dangling a sign from your neck reading, "Purge my purse." Oh, the righteous right bill may pity you, dear lady, but few else.
Righteous. Righteous ain't never been to my liking, mate. I just can't abide them
reprobates.
What? Hmm? I can't. Sheesh. No. Stop it. No. Okay. What don't honor the creed of sky pirating? Or so you can imagine Red Bull Lenford might say anyway, eh? Not that it's any matter of ours, anyhow. Should you find someone looking to offload our debaucherous...
Dubious
attained merchandise, send them our way, will you? I think he kind of ruined your charade there, bud.
If you insist, but don't say I didn't warn you. Okay.
Last one. Is it on the Gobby Factory?
Here? I think so.
Yeah. Oh, like actual Gobby. Oh boy. Oh boy. Yes, yes, Gobby eye catches, such as steel stealers come to claim busy deal at Craft Forge, but bring no trade goods for Jingleshine. Great laugh joke for Gobby merchants. Sky stealers leave with grumpy face. Gobby does not understand why uplanders wish to trade tongue flaps with grump face sky stealers, but happy to hand lead for more laugh jokes. The gobbies are fun.
They do.
Your gibberish is always a good read. Much obliged. If all goes to plan, we'll have you laugh joking all over their sorry hides for summers to come. Great happiness for Gobby uplanders. Gobby shares one more laugh joke. Sky Stealers whine cry about calling strong friend as they shame run. Friend may be strong, but Sky Stealers brain cases are still outright airy light. What?
I'm calling them stupid.
Literally. But in Gobby, if a Gobby is calling you stupid, you are very dumb. Right?
Oh, I bet.
Where are we going?
Airy light. Oh, that was too good.
Peloton. Oh, we have a talk point.
No.
And a cutscene talk point, no less. Oh no. You know when this music starts playing, you know it's not good.
Yeah.
So, are we the talk of the town yet?
As far as I can tell, you're strong contenders. Perhaps second only to rumors about a mysterious intimidator who cast their lots in with the cockatoos.
Only natural that those shivering whelps hired a bow breather, but what thickhead
Quartz.
The rancor of Red Bill Lanford. Leoford, sorry. Well, I suppose a few names come to mind, but no matter, our plan proceeds as discussed. Let's take to the streets and wait for our clients to come crawling, eh? I like the new Goofy music. Oh, we have our walking cutscene. Oh, do you want to be the sky pirate number one?
Sure. Well, there. Are you the trader looking to shuffle with the monstrous cockatoos?
That smile. Chaffer, with snags like you, fury end me. I don't know whether to laugh or cry.
That voice, Red Bill Lilfrey?
As you live and breathe. Not for long, though. If you don't hand over what you and your dirty bird stole.
Your dicky bird.
Sorry! I can't read. English is a lie. Ohio Quilla.
Bluster all you like, Red Bill, but you ain't getting the better of us this time. We've treated with a sky pirate that'll crush you to comments.
Yeah, have you now? And there you were, thinking this would be so ever so simple. Were you not, my dear Leoford? Oh boy. Would be it? Oh! Okay.
Ah, yes, her.
I don't remember her very much, but you did the Sky of Pirates not long ago. Who, can you lightly remind me who she is?
A thorn.
Okay.
Annoyance.
Okay.
I don't like her.
Not in the slightest. I was thinking surely Rildia and her talons would never sink so low as to become lackeys to a lackey. But here you are! I might even start to pity you. And that is where you consistently underestimate me, Red Bill. I would stop at nothing to realize my desires. There were the sweet memories we made together in Dunscaith not enough to convince you of that? But I suppose I might be willing to overlook your stubborn indifference and return those stolen airship parts you so desperately seek, if you would but call me your captain. Oh no. How about we beat him up? I like that.
My hands know only knows equality. My hands for all.
Completing that airship means more to me than you will ever understand. I ain't leaving here without the me stolen goods. If they're won't worth recovering, that is. You there. Akarum. You didn't leave that plunder in the winds aspected territory, did you? Of course you did. Heads as empty as a tosspot tankard. Those airship parts are embranded with highly Help.
Wait, what?
Highly calibrated corrupted crystals. Put them in any put in any contact with wind's air sprites, and they're no better than gullified scrap.
Wait a moment, he said contact, didn't he? How many wind sprites go contacting the rock formations on Providence, eh? It'll be fine.
Ultra, you've got your hands on an airship, yes? Take them to Providence and go pick up our stolen goods. Some genius hid them under a rock. Nice. You were bluffing. Obviously. Don't make me doubt your intelligence. Rildia? What airship needs parts that can't handle a little wind? Doubt what you'd like, Linford, but I hardly need bloody airship parts to beat you into submission. You clearly did. Well, okay, we're fighting now.
Whee!
Finally, it's beating time. Let me slip into something more comfortable. Which one are we going with? I'm very tempted with the top one.
Yeah, let's go with it.
Oh, we just
we just crouched down and we take off our clothes.
Would you excuse me
getting changed? Amber, Aclaria.
What the fuck? Did you just say Amber and Aclaria as in D-Amber? Yes, idiot. As in D, Aclaria and Amber? Since when were they friends of the Red Bills?
Seems I'm not the only one whose name is worth something in these parts. I'm still prettier, though.
Oh, fuck off.
Well then, sweet cockatoos, let's get about cutting you up into cockatees and fours, shall we?
Red Bill by himself is something, but Ever and Clara is something else. And nothing for it, let's.
Run!
Bye!
Bye! Flee for your lives! So much for monstrous. Let's leave them to the garrison. Ain't enough meat on their shivering bones to warrant the chase. Rydia. I reckon this was a little more than an aversion for it to you. But surely you don't think I'd fouled? To such a weak hand, thank you. All the more pity that you assumed those airship parts were the only pieces of value taken from me and mine. But no matter. It's time to make your allegiances clear. If you and your talons intend to complete this farce, then we'll have it out here and now. Well, I have a feeling they're gonna run. It seems I misjudged my prospects. I had thought those simpletons might amount to more than shivering turntails, but I have neither loyalty nor affection for a useless cockatoo. I suppose I shall have to be contend myself with this reunion in itself, but you will need more than clever bluffs to evade me next time, and that you may be certain. Sure. Why do we let her leave so that she can try again?
We change to fight. Come on!
We're too well known, Aclaria. They know not to tassel with us. I don't miss the days when they underestimated us. Come on. I remember when bandits were like, who's this wee adventurer? Surely
who's this rando?
Who's this rando? How dare you? And then proceeds to get pounded into the floor. And then, like, we're very well known now for, like, crushing deities and gods. So, yeah, running would be what I would do if I was them, too. Anyway. Those were some fine samples, without question, but nothing beats wearing me old rags again. Go ahead to the Pratt Rock, and wait for us in my chambers. Oh ho! We'll be along once I've spoken to our knights most thornly. Well. Shall I teleport us there, or do you wish to?
I can.
I got it.
Oh, are you?
Ah, I see you. Why am I flying so slow? There we go.
Yeah, sometimes I don't know why.
I think this is an instant area that we can't see each other in, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Enter Lee of Horde's chambers.
Hell yeah. I mean...
Buy me dinner first. Like all my other boys have done. Right?
I mean, is he not dinner already?
I call you.
Yes. I'll
I love it. Well, Altas says all stolen property is accounted for and finishing touches on our airship proceed apace.
And according to the Rose Knights, the cockatoos will be shipped off to the Diadem where they can enjoy volunteering their services for the betterment of mankind.
Enjoy the Diadem. That is actual punishment. Not gonna actual lie. Punishment. Being shipped off to Diadem. Oh, damn.
Too good.
I remember when I had to, when I was there, I did all of the grinding.
I still have to go there because I am doing my Guy Steel relics for partners. Oh no.
You're Ketsith as well.
No. Am I?
Yes.
Yeah. Fuck, I forgot.
Yeah, I'm the Lala.
What is to become of the miscellanea recovered from the cockatoo's hoard? I'm sure House Helena will lay claim to the possessors, but as for the appurtenances of origin unknown, English, cat, speak English. Ironic.
Worry not, puss. I don't pocket any jug bog. I find, like, some petty fister. We'll track down the rightful place soon enough, if my proceedings holds. Oh, Tartaru! Would you like to be Tartaru, or do you want me to be Tartaru?
I can be Tartaru here.
Okay.
Amber, Eclaira, is that you? No, it's all an illusion, my dear.
But there's somebody with Tartaru and everything. Cool.
It is. And you look quite as surprised as I feel. Today we meet here amongst the clouds and sky pirates. I was just finishing up my affairs in Aethershire when we should come asking for me. But who should come asking for me but Redbill Leofort? Quite the thrilling twist to my day, I'll have you know.
How did Amelin put it? She's got her fingers in more pies than a high street baker. When I got wind, she was... No. I feel like every time I'm going to sneeze, it's not good.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
When she was in Aethershire, it felt like snubbing fate not to enlist her expertise.
Well, I'm exceedingly glad you did, for I have returned triumphant. Allow me to present the famous traveling portraitist Duramert. Portraitist, but of course, among the recovered items were a number of singularly beautiful paintings.
Oh, I am relieved to hear it. When I learned which vessel had fallen prey to sky pirates, I thought those pieces would be lost forever.
So you're yet another victim of the monstrous cockatoos. Still, a personal summons to the Peric seems like the sort of societal 90s, to which the captain is normally intolerant. Fucking eyes, I can't get over it.
I like that you're the cat. It's good. You like being the cat?
I like being a cat, but her goddamn eyes. Her goddamn eyes.
I believe my presence here may have another purpose entirely. You see, Linford and I are old acquaintances. He commissioned me to paint the portrait, in fact.
Not surprised.
Oh, that portrait. My beautiful daughter, Ramelaine. She looks perfectly at home here.
That's his grandpa.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful daughter?
Aye, Dermot is the daughter to Lady Ramil, the gentlewoman who cared for Leofred as a lad. He abdicated all the family affairs to his son when he became a practicing artist, but he's still a lord in lineage. You mean to say that the renowned portraitist Dermot is not only your grandfather but a former lord as well? Oh, you must forgive my blithe introduction from earlier.
Not to forgive, Mistress Tataru. On the contrary, I'm indebted to you for tracking him down so quickly. Thanks to you, this can happen just as I had hoped it might. Construction is about finished on the new airship, and I wanted you here when I christened her. The Remail will fly again. My dear boy, celebrating your mother's life with you continues to be my great honor. When you hung her portrait here, when you named your first airship, I could see the vestiges of her love shining in your countenance. Then, just as it is now, I only hope you continue to realize her greatest wish for you, to live as free and as unfeathered as the sky itself. I know she would be very proud. A bit like herding corals, ain't it? Getting us adventuring types all in one room. But well worth the effort, I'd say. Moments like these are meant to be shared. Right, I believe we've got a new airship to fly, and new skies, open skies await. They could open a new map of the sky, cloud sea, couldn't they? Right?
I haven't looked at the map properly for a long time.
The cat's fine. With how she handles, I could fly to the edge of existence and back without so much as a hiccup. Which I hear in good authority is whatever authority a Menelin is when he's in pups. What?
When he's drinking.
You have literally done. I reckon I've never been such equal parts odd and envious. Though, I assume me inventions was...
Invitations
was simply lost by the post Moogle.
Oh, no.
Lol. Nay, all in candor. I am certain there were some skies only meant for your eyes. Escapades? Right? Surpassing even my wildest imaginings. So church to the ends of eternity, the horizon filled with peril. Just don't think you've seen the last of what wonders these heavens hold. Yeah, there we go. Right? New map is very much on the table, right?
Yeah.
This is Yoshi P literally hinting, oh, you have seen nothing yet. I'll come find you again before long, Amber and Eclaria, and I'll bring everything I've always promised. That shrilling head rush of high adventure. Thank you. Okay. Whee!
It would have been so much better if we see a dangling mandolin by the rope.
One day.
One day. So farewell may be a bitter sorrow, know that it is but fodder for reunions most gay.
No need to get mankish for a ball. It ain't as if Amber's dropping off the face of the star. Not permanently, anyhow.
We'll meet again soon enough. Although Kid Safe is liable to mop like a damn kitten till we do.
Aww. The cat misses us.
Of course.
I expect these parts will be free of half-baked baguettes for a time yet. But should you ever find yourself in need of Red Bill, don't hesitate to call.
Thank you. 'Tis no small comfort knowing our ships may distribute that our ships may distribute their wares in safety.
As for you, Amber, we'll be in touch. As for you, Amber and Eclaria, we'll be in touch. Wink. Could you imagine if he winked at us?
Uh-huh. I can't even with these people. Well, that was invigorating. Well, I love nothing more than to catch our collective breath over a cup of tea. Business calls me to Ishgard. No rest for the enterprising and the talented, as they say. Shall we, Dermot?
Sorry, this theme, though.
It's so good.
It's so good. It's the Final Fantasy theme. It's the theme that is always at the end of every series, all across the series. It's so good.
Yeah.
This is the theme I literally cried to.
Oh no.
Anyway. Might I preserve you to accompany
Persuade you.
I'm distracted by song. I should very much like to hear of your adventures. Sorry. Painting subjects I find personally inspiring is particularly Creed-do of mine.
I've never seen
and
this word
I
before.
I dare say you have brushed shoulders with more than a few individuals of note. I mean, yeah.
Yes, I'm bestie with the queen.
I'm besties with a lot of people. Thank you for indulging an old man's in what? Now then, perhaps you could begin with the adventures you shared with Lanford and his crewmates. What did he drop?
Milford intentionally offloaded this in our direction, yes? Whatever could it be?
Whatever it is, Lanford's a man of his word.
Mm-hmm.
A show of goodwill from the Red Bills. Was second option?
Yeah. Not mysterious, but now that I think of it, Leofred did mention sending something along when he asked me to track down Jeremiah. Well, I would make quite the sight lugging this around to all my meetings, so might I ask you to hold on to it for the time being? I trust you not to run off with my share of the reward. I'm pretty sure if we ever tried, Totoro would just hunt us down.
We would never be able to hide from Tarotaro. Her connections are everywhere.
He's scary. A gift from the notorious Red Bills. You know, they're rather a nice sort of sky pirate, don't you think?
I mean, we can ask Astinian. He tried, right?
He tried.
He tried. And then like hid from Tarotaro so much that she got so annoyed, she hired another Lalavel to track him down.
No, and then it got him so annoyed that he just gave up and just believed me come. It's like, fuck it.
The Kryl and Tartaru literally followed him for ages, and he was like, how are they keep finding me?
The elf is afraid of the little elf.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we're back in Ishgard. Sorry. Hiya, Clara.
Oh, hello.
A bright and angelic young lady is your employer, Amber Eclaria. I hope shepherding me back to Ishgard did not delay your business over long. The tales you shared on the journey here were beyond anything I could have anticipated. Never have I heard such inspiring episodes of daring do. Though I may not know them personally, I find myself fascinated by the individuals you described. The comrades and acquaintances of your journeys, yes, I believe I shall remain in the capital to paint for a time. Should you desire a portrait, I would happily part with it for the cost of its supplies. Find me here and we can make arrangements.
What?
Like, really?
Can we really, please?
I look forward to talking to you, taking up my brush. Let us speak again once you have fulfilled your current obligations. God damn it.
Okay, I guess we have to go back to old Charlene.
Mm-hmm. Who gets there first? Me.
I have returned, so...
Oh. Wait.
I said... Okay, the thing is, I said old Charlene as my,
But casting return will not cast exactly. The teleport for me. So just take the teleport request, Eclaria.
Fine. I'm going. I have tickets. Just use it.
I don't have tickets.
Yeah, that's why I just shoot wrong button. But I have tickets. So if I try to put this ticket, it's fine. But I went to the moon.
Bro, you went... Did you really?
I did. I was supposed to go and click like, oh, Charlotte. And then I scroll and then I just clicked something. I was like, don't know what I was doing.
That's amazing.
I was like, the bunnies.
Welcome back. I just received word from Mistress Tataru. What's this about paint portraits and sky pirates? Well, you know, just the usual. Redbill Leonfort gave you this for the necklace. It seems to be a leather strap of sorts, an acquired one at that. Antique one at that. Wait a minute, I recognize the design from my studies. This This is a relic of the ancient city of Mach. It was said that Mach sorcerers would weave these cords with magics to make them unbreakable. You'd be hard-pressed to find better material for a necklace. Oh, Mr. Sitaru will be so delighted. She chatted endlessly about how pleased she was to know the red bills and what sort of products might prove useful to our daring friend, new friends. And the Rose Knights have always placed an order for the garrison, so all in all, I believe our latest endeavor was a brilliant success. As always, we shall be on the lookout for new areas of opportunity. So I hope you can we can count on your service as our charming emissary again. In fact, I believe Mr. Sitaru will enlist upon it next time. Until next time. I can read. I am a good reader. You may now purchase portraits from Dermot by speaking to him in Ishgard. We can? Nani?
Yeah.
Cool. Well. Let's continue, shall we?
Mm-hmm.
Ah, Amber, Eclaria, you couldn't have come at a better time. I know. Our timing.
Yeah, it's not like we were just standing here.
It's not like we were just standing here. Do you have a moment to talk? Of course. For you, anytime. My thanks. You see, a foreign merchant approached the boutique with a proposal not long ago. Hancock from the Eastern Alderna Trading Company. Perhaps you've heard of him. Mm-hmm. We know of Hancock. Hancock is great. He's a good dude.
Yeah.
His boss is not great, but him himself is good. He's a good bud.
Yeah.
Ah, so you have history. No wonder Mrs. Jotaro declined him unscrupulously deserving an infinite caution. He's fine, his boss isn't, right?
Yeah.
Though there are risks in dealing with a man such flexible principles. His knowledge of the Hingen markets would do much to bolster our efforts to make inroads in the Far East. I would agree. This is why, despite her misgivings, Mrs. Tataru seeks to negotiate a partnership. But for some reason or another, he has requested you be present in the meeting in Kugane.
No.
Oh, no wonder. I wonder why. I realize business negotiations are not your forte. Yeah.
Excuse you?
Do you not know that we Warrior of Lights are crafters and businessmen all the time?
Dude, we Omnicrafter, bro.
We Omnicrafter, bro. But we would be most grateful if you'd indulge his request. Of course, there are also matters of our secret mission. Of course. Yes. Once it's been fully restored, this gorgeous sapphire will serve as the centerpiece of Mistress Tataru's necklace. I hope that one day she may look upon it as a memento of not only her mother, but as many dear friends and allies. Is that the same line she said the last time as well?
It's like slightly changed.
Okay. Perhaps during your visit to Kugane, fortune will shall favor us with the discovery of an additional treasure to grace her keepsake. I'm sure. In any case, I believe that covers everything. Mr. Stataro shall meet you at the Ruby Bazaar in Kugane. I wish you a safe journey. Okay. To Kugane, Eclaria.
Oh. Indeed, we shall go.
And you got there first. You faced.
Yeah.
Okay. We could just teleport.
Yeah, but I just did that. The Ruby Bazaar.
It's been a while. Where are we going? This way?
Yeah.
Destination! I see it.
Oh!
Over here.
I got a new mission. Yeah, I still got a lot of like quests I need to do. But that wasn't important.
I did all the quests here, so I have nothing else for this.
I had it turned off, but like...
Oh, we get to sit on a bench! I'll just imagine you're sitting next to me.
I don't know,
my hands through my skirt. My hands are through my skirt.
Yeah, that's the one thing about that outfit.
The clipping.
Yeah, it's
I might look, I don't worry about it, but like when Square Enix bring up clipping, I'm like, it is a reason for them not bringing in shit, and I'm like, but there's so much clipping with all stuff. Just
yeah, it literally. Your hair.
Just
one
look,
of the hair
we,
that you have.
We ignore it. We ignore it. You know? We ignore it. It's fine. If it's clips, it's fine. We just work around the clipping. Occasionally. Anyway, sorry. And we're getting distracted, Eclaria.
Amber, Eclaria, I'm so glad you could make it.
I am equally thrilled by your arrival. Though I must apologize for the sudden invitation. It's fine.
It's fine, I'll beat you after this.
Yes, you should.
Oh,
sorry, I thought it was Hancock talking there.
Yes, you should. But more importantly, I'd like to know what the scheme is and how you intend to involve us.
Oh my, so quick to assume the worst.
Can't help it with your boss.
That look!
So cute.
It's so cute! Coming from a Lalafell, it's evil, but it's so cute.
It is.
While I would love to nothing more than to lay bare all my dirty little secrets, 'twould be prudent to discuss my proposal first. Loath though I am to admit it, a dripper shop, but recently launched by the company, has not been well received by the locals. Our intention was to promote the sale of imported appeal woven by the Hulda Weavers Guild. Alas, it seems Western fashion holds little appeal for the citizens of Kugane. So, we rethought our strategy. We would produce Hingen Pertur? But with world-renowned Uldan silk, kimono, as they are favored favored choice of wear in the Far East. Or rather, that was the plan until our semester seamstress fell ill. You want me to do it? I can do it. I'm a level 90 weaver. I'm good. I could do it.
We can do this.
Got this, bro. It was as I faced an unpleasant decision of abandoning this venture entirely that I chanced to hear of Tartaru's boutique and the associated Far Eastern styled equipment they had on offer.
You're referring to a samurai and ninja inspired set of armor, yes?
I haven't seen that yet. Indeed, by putting your exemplary goods on display, the Eastern Alnrad Trading Company would demonstrate that we, a Western trader, are capable of making garments suited to the needs of our local patrons. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I have been informed that you wish to establish a foothold in the Hingashi and East Aldenard. What better way to make your Kugane debut than to make us showcase your quality wares?
It's not without its appeal, I admit. The perfect venue to gauge interest in our goods.
Isn't it just? If I may take your brooding concession as a sign of interest, perhaps we can discuss the finer points of my proposal partnership.
Oh, we'll be discussing it at length, but I've yet to see how any of this would require Ember Declara's involvement.
Indeed, I was just about to get to that part. Yes. Not long ago, I crossed paths with a group of certain someones who were eager to call on Ember and Eclaria again. I found myself quite taken with them, charming as they were, that I felt compelled to facilitate this reunion. And of course, no one can collect too many favors. Alas, I know that you are not predisposed to question the motives behind any invitation from the East Aldenard Trading Company. I mean, every time I hear the name, I think it's too long.
East Aldenard Trading Company. That's all I see.
That would assume the Alpha Node, it's Alpha Nodes, but it's not.
Just let him take over a bit. Sooner or later, it's gonna be his. It's fine.
And with good cause, I concede. So I instead invited you under the guise of assisting Tataru with a boutique-related affair. I hope you will forgive me the deception. It's common when everything and time Hancock is involved, there's always deception involved, right? Why? Mm-hmm. I feel like they need to be deceptive for us to pique our interest, because otherwise we won't come, right? Mm-hmm. Rest assured that you shall be rewarded for your aid on this matter with your choice of recompense. Just before your arrival, I took the liberty of of informing your new acquaintances that you will be soon be making landfall on these shores. They ask that you seek them at Sanzakui in the Ruby Sea as soon as you are able. Look! I'm not
Sakazuki.
Good. Look, I can't. The words are hard. Dyslexic brain. I believe it is a matter of some urgency. So if you could travel there forthwith. Excellent. I leave them in your capable hands.
Don't worry, I'm no stranger to Hancock's tricks. I'll make sure not to agree to anything until we settle every last detail. Just do what you need to, and return when you can. I mean, she spent the entire life storm blood with him. She knows.
She's used to his tricks.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
I think No. Fastest way is to just leave. Where's the teleport crystal? There it is.
No, there is also another way. You just go to the teleport.
Yeah, and we go to the Ruby Sea.
No, and then just take the ship.
We could. It's an instant. But like I just.
You're just gonna fly over?
Yeah.
Alright.
I'm waiting for you. I'm waiting.
Yeah, coming.
Oh no, you're here. Hi.
Hello.
Woo. You remember when Alpha Node jumped into the water?
I love that scene so much. The thing is, because I was stuck at this particular quest where he keeps jumping into the water, so I get to rewatch it again and again and again. I love it.
Good times. And I don't get why people don't like Stormblood. There's so much love. There's so much to love.
There's
about
a
it.
Lot of moment. It's just.
Where's the book?
It's there behind it.
Where?
Just down.
Oh! I'm blind.
I thought you just kept down. Juicy.
I can't click on it. There we go. I was looking for a person. Not a destination.
They say wait though. So
okay, do you want to be Soroban?
Sure. Apologies, Ember and Eclaria. I pray you have not been waiting long. Oh, hello, God. Casually walking up the shores, have you?
Hey, Soroban!
Hello, bestie. You look surprised. Did Hancock not tell you who requested your aid?
No.
Ah, but never mind then. I am simply glad that you're here. I mean, it's pretty obvious. He is literally on the picture of the quest. How have I been while my training as the next Gambu continues apace? I must tell you, my friend, each day has been more trying than the last. Why, just the other day, the auspicious placed 99 wasabi-filled takoyaki on a platter before me and instructed me to divine which single ball of the entire batch was not filled with that dreadful spice. Training to sharpen my foresight, they claim, but it felt more akin to torture. By then, I was reduced to a dithering sea turtle swimming in a puddle of my own tears. Fucking Soroban is the best. That is all to say, I am only marginally closer to assuming my place as one of the four lords. Get to the point already, Soroban.
Ah,
I was just about to arrive at it.
Bah! Get to the point already, Soroban!
Oh my god. It's the angle, it's amazing. Let's get to it. Come, my friend, show yourselves.
You're ahead of me. I didn't know you read that line. Sorry.
It's fine. I'm just laughing at the fucking angles that they give us. It's amazing.
Yeah! All our buddies!
And the sim.
Hey, the big cat. Big kitty.
Oh, he's so cute.
He's so cute. It's been some time, Amber, Eclaria. Hey, Biako. Who do you want, the snake or the bird?
I'm fine with either.
Okay,
so
you can be the bird, I'll be the snake.
Fine, I'll be the simp. I'm relieved to see you in good health. I understand you have been through a great deal.
Your concern is unwarranted. This is the woman who quelled our ultimatum and inherited Tanzan's legacy. There is no trial she can't overcome. Thank you, Snake.
You misunderstood me, my brother. That, or you deliberately insinuated that I lack faith in Amber and Claire's capabilities.
Enough. We are indebted ourselves to the merchant to obtain this meeting. Let us not distract ourselves with this nonsense and get to the heart of the matter. Very well. You may not know this, but Sinri's craving for Sinri's craving for Dango often brings her to Gogane. It was during such a visit she spied a suspicious individual on the Kogane Dori, a man who not only wore romance idolizing two Tanzons, but who also claimed to be his long-lost descendant.
Ooh.
This descendant was selling good luck charms. And utterly devoid of the benediction?
Mm-hmm.
Utterly devoid of benediction. The cure spell.
Yes.
Okay. His plight is plain. He uses Tanzan's name to trick fools into buying his rubbish.
Any who dare sully Tenzin's name shall face my wrath. My flames will cleanse him of his sin and burn his soul to ash.
See, this was perfect. See, the bird was perfect for you.
What do you mean?
What do I mean? You would burn things to ash, right?
It is true. No, burning things can be fun, okay.
Burning things can be fun. I can find it for you. One sec. What is Kaz looking up?
Kaz wanted to say that I should like fenter my retainer to look like Emmerich, but I'm pretty sure it's impossible to like recreate Emmerich's like face. You can create Graha, but I don't think Emmerich is possible.
I think it should be very possible. Also, I like Basil fire emote.
Basil beast.
Too merciful a punishment, I say. I shall personally render unto him every pain imaginable.
By the Kami, is it possible they have both succumbed to the Aramtama once more?
No, they're just simps.
Saruman, please.
Ahem. The charlatan boasts them of more than an esteemed heritage. He also claims to have the four lords at his beck and call? Insinuating, yes. Insulting, yes. But I would still rather resolve this without flames and torture. Really? Gabu, come on. Flames and torture are fun! But having lived apart from men for so long, I fear we may be ill-equipped to do so on our own. Hence why we have turned to you for assistance. You needn't agree to anything just yet, but why don't we all go seek out this descendant and take his measure ourselves?
I beg your pardon? Putting myself aside, the three of you approaching any settlement, let alone one as large as Kugane, would surely cause an uproar.
That is true. A giant snake, a giant cat, and a bird flying through town. I think people would start talking. Calm yourself, Sorban. You forget we are the four lords. It is a trifling matter to assume a less conspicuous guise. I'm gonna turn into a smaller cat, smaller snake, and smaller bird? Let us reconvene in Kugane. Sorban is to go first, while we three shall make our approach separately to avoid attracting undue attention, just in case. So our band's like, no, why? Why me?
Always me, god damn it.
I like having a big kitty cat walking next to me though. Hey kitty. Oh my god.
Yeah,
oh my god. What? This is less conspicuous?
I'm having PTSD of bunnies right now. Please don't do this to me.
You got a white bunny, a blue bunny, and a red chicken.
All I see is the weird Lalafell, the other weird Lalafell, and freaking Shadows Glam.
Yeah, I was just about to say this is Shadows Glam.
It is horrifying.
But Shadows are wearing the chicken suit too, so... Oh my god. I can't. This game... I forget not to take it too seriously. This is gonna be hard.
It will seem we have managed to arrive with Little Fuss. This... It's Little Fuss. But only the Kami know how long our presence will remain a secret. You think this will keep you out?
Maybe if we dress up as bunnies and chickens too, we'll fit right in. Again, with needless worry, our disguises are perfect. Sure.
None may suspect you are the four lords at first glance, but you're suspicious in the extreme. I fucking love Sorobun.
But we have used our powers to assume the form of men. But those are keen sight would still be able to discern our true nature. These costumes were... And
innocuous.
Alternative. Thank you.
There's nothing innocuous about them.
Funny heads turning on tandem is fucking hilarious.
Why are they like this?
I fair disguise now. Found this now. Yep, perfect disguises.
Senri said she found the swindler on Kogane Dorius. Let us head there at once. Fucking hell, I'd rather you turn into an actual bird and just fly.
Oh my god, I'm crying. This is too much. I'm in tears.
I'm choking on my fucking notes.
Oh look, it's another Asahi guy, dude.
Nah, I would say Asahi looks better.
Okay.
To be fair.
Do you want to be this guy or do you want me to be this guy?
I can be. Get around, friends, get around. As you have no doubt surmised from my crimson armor, I am the proud descendant of Tenzin, the famous hero of Eld who once slew an entire host of fearsome Oni. Yes, very sus, I know. But do not take my word for it. Behold. In this hand, I hold Tenzin's beloved katana, the Phoenix Blade. Man.
I don't know what it looks like, but if he's got the Phoenix Blade, then he must be who he claims.
Oh, that's the dumbest.
Shit I've ever come up with.
No, because... I just realized what he says. He's the co-conspirator, of course.
Ah, that makes sense.
Yes.
Anyway. Idiots. The true blade has remained in our care since Tenzin's passing.
I can't. I'm standing next to the chicken, that's it.
Yep.
I'm losing it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm losing it.
Something seems off.
I see there are some who remain unconvinced. Very well, you leave me no choice. Allow me to introduce you to my sworn allies, the Four Lords.
Oh yes, boy,
they are
oh
in
boy.
Chicken suits and funny outfits, yes.
I mean, I'm just waiting for them to be all chickens. Alright, who are the Four Lords? His Four Lord friends. I can't not wait. Oh dear, I'm almost afraid to look.
Oh no. I just.
That's your signal. Oh boy.
I expect my money's worth. The fuck? And deducing Gambu, the turtle Ospers, and Foreseer of Calamity.
Okay.
The fuck? Suzaku, the Avian Auspice and Master of the Flame of Resurrection. Shiryu, the Dragon Auspice and Devourer of Young Maidens. Oh no. Why did he drop the cat from the sky? Why does he look so sad? Last but not least adorable, we have Darko, the small and fluffy feline Oshkosh.
I mean, Byakko is a cat. What did we expect? But I was to be the fluff.
Yeah.
Meow. I was expecting a cat girl, but you know what?
I was expecting a cat boy.
Yeah, that too. Why am I alone, a cuddly creature? Surely he could have hired a Hrothgar or Makote to what? There's two cat races. Damn. At least
the Budinese are not impressed.
At least he did not slander your character Devourer of young maidens. Ah. What is this rabble? All who've heard the tale of Tenzin know that the four lords are beasts, not three mummers and a cat.
Oh, I have faith in game humanities now. These are the glamoured form they assume so they may roam the realms of men undiscovered. Surely you can imagine the chaos they would ensue if they were about undisguised. Yes, but a cat.
Even so, there's no way they'd wear such ridiculous outfits. Their outfits are normal, sir. If you look to your right, there's the ridiculousness over there. There's ridiculousness way over there, okay? These are normal.
Look, these are fashionables, okay? I fucking love Sarapa. He's such a comedy genius. And yet here they are, dressed in flowers.
Sarapan, I love him so much.
He's the best.
He's so good.
This farce is infuriating. I will not abide him making mock of the bonds we shared with Tenzin.
Okay, bird. We are of one mind, my sister. He must be silenced.
We are gonna hire a mafia.
I'm just waiting for the attack of the bunnies.
The two bunny jumping on him?
Yeah. Does Tenzin even have a descendant? There was nothing in the legends of him faming any children. Faming any children.
But there was mention of one who loved him more dearly than life itself. The woman to whom I owe my storied lineage is none other than the sublime crimson beauty standing before you, Suzaku.
Wow.
He is. Unimpressed.
Oh boy.
Excuse me, woman, what did you just say? Let him speak. Perhaps he is not wholly deserving of emulation. No, woman. Bird, please.
Bird.
You did not just nod.
Bah. How easily your rage is quelled.
Having proven my ancestry to your satisfaction, my lords and ladies, I bid you partake of my good fortune, for I have auspicious wares to share with you today. Tenzin put countless Oni to the sword long ago. Tis true, but only by the grace of these miraculous good luck charms. Just one will confer onto you all manner of fortune. Good health, a happy family, scholarly achievement, financial success, romantic fulfillment, and much, much more. This Sweet. Is such a Asian scam. It's so Asian. It is so Asian. You
Here's
can't
the thing. Here's the
up.
Thing. As a foreigner, I will fall prey to these Asian scams if I go to Japan. Okay. I will buy all of the good luck charms. I will buy all of the good luck charms. Okay.
Amber, I have first-hand experience. No good luck charm has ever made me pass math. Just saying.
Money Japan.
No, you can go to any Asian country and there's a certain scam like this for sure, word for word. All of this achievement is the same. But that's not all. Purchase a charm now and I'll even throw in a stylish strap featuring of the Four Lords design of your choosing. What the fuck is this merchandise? My stock is limited, so be sure to buy while supplies
last. Sounds like something that Square Enix would say.
They're having their own game to play.
They're saying that while stocks last.
Well,
I feel like we've heard that saying before. I feel like that's something that's been said before. Oh, it's too good. This game is too good. I'll take 10!
No, no, no.
My blood boils to see Tenzin's good name used in this manner. Bunny mad. As does mine. We can't sit idly by and allow this to continue. I can't take them seriously. Please take off the outfits.
You can please say something, please.
Oh my god. I think our purveyor of good fortune is in need of a proper scare. Are you convinced as well, Amber? Oh yeah. But take off the bunny outfits and the chicken suit, please. I can't take them seriously with them wearing this shit.
Please stop. Just take it off. Please, pick up me, please. Woman, take it off!
I need to get food before we go into the raid. What time are we doing near? Soon?
Right after we finish this quest, then we can start getting people. So, after we finish this quest, you go get your food while I see who can join.
Okay. You will gather party as your Lala. You will go Lala recruiting while I
yes.
Food.
The Lala recruitment drive.
The Lala recruitment drive shall happen. Okay, cool.
Yes.
Okay, Sarban.
What? Could you stop? Hello.
Are you okay?
The doggo is just barking at random noises. I don't know why. He seemed quite pleased with himself as he packed up his store. Business was good, no doubt. How shall we proceed? Rob him.
Rob him? With care and preparation. We shall... We all saw how... Definitely. He countered accusations of fraud. A more clever approach is needed. We must limit his activity to spin more lies. Have you any ideas, Amber? And Eclaria. I could persuade myself as Tenzin's true descendant. I could persuade of... the presence of the four lords should be more than enough to convince him.
Not dressed like this.
Dressed like this, though.
Like, actually, no.
I'm going with the second option.
but
not in these outfits, please.
Yeah, definitely not in this outfit.
Oh ho! Indeed, our very existence alone is enough to prove his claims false. Then it is settled. We shall play the role of... You shall play the role of Tenzin. Oh, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, the matter.
Okay, so you shall play the role of Trenzin's true descendant, and we shall accompany you. With us at your side, the imposter will have no choice but to confess his crimes. Still, we would be wise to prepare for contingencies. With me, Sorban, we make for Risen Temple.
Please change your outfit.
Please, and we beg.
I'm on my knees.
Pray.
I'm on my knees.
Then it is up to us to find and confront the swindler. As you are familiar with the city, I bid you lead the way and speak with Suzaku when you are ready. Okay. Suzaku.
His customers may have seen where he went, so let us begin by questioning them.
I would also know more about his true identity. Of all the heroes of legend, why claim Tenzin's name? The answer may help us stop him without resorting to violence, since some of you apparently lack the stomach for it. Okay, they're both accompanying us. We have a chicken and a rabbit. Just the chicken.
It's not creepy at all.
Just the chicken? No. Both are following.
No.
Help! I'm being attacked! Help!
Leave me alone.
Okay,
please.
Where are we going?
I'm assuming back here.
We're trying to find this guy.
Are they?
There we go. Suspicious woman.
Superstitious woman.
Kami be praised to have met Tenzin's descendant and get a good luck charm besides. What a fool I was to doubt him. He who commands the four lords of legend. As long as I have this, fortune shall surely shine upon me.
Hello, Damis.
Oh, has my good luck charm caught your eye? If you wanted one for yourself, you are sadly out of luck. The merchant selling them said that was the last of his stock, and he did not think he would be able to acquire more. But if you wish to hear more from him, he was heading towards Turshgan Bridge. You will know him by his attire. I swear it was the spitting image of Tenzin from the storybooks.
She speaks of yonder bridge, does she not? Others may have taken note of our query as he passed. Okay, then let's go to the bridge then, shall we?
Which bridge?
I still get lost here, so...
This one. You couldn't be this guy.
Okay. Have I seen a man claiming to be Tenzin's descendant? The one who was selling good luck charms by the dozen, you mean? No, he didn't come this way. But Kami gave me strength. I'll never understand how some can be so gullible.
Let us continue our search elsewhere. Well, look who it is. Oh.
Oh, fucking hell.
We needed something else to make this situation more hilarious. It was quite some time. What brings you to Kogane this eve? Hi, fish. How's it going?
I'm gonna kill you again.
A hawker claiming to be Tenzin's ascendant. Probably Ishun. I saw him not long ago. Yes. You know him. My peculiar and suspicious friend, there is no merchant in Kugane who hasn't heard of the entrepreneur. He's made a fortune masquerading as a Tenzin's heir. It's a brilliant scheme. Very profitable. Oh boy. You are about to be a cooked fish.
Ugh.
Burning an Amazu is a crime, right?
No, it's not.
tried to get in on it myself, but the Baron will suffer no competition.
Who's this Baron of whom you speak?
The soy sauce one. Wells.
Kageyama? No! Not my Kageyama, please.
And we have suddenly gone to the realm of anime land. Kageyama gave up basketball and chose to live in the world of 14. No one could blame the man. A dangerous man, yes, with fingers, oh my god, in every pie. Mm-hmm. I mean, I fear him almost as much as I envy him. Their deception must be exposed. What can you tell us of Ishin? How many times do I have to teach the Baron the same lesson? Do I know this person? Do you have a third option too, Eclaria? Or do I just...
Yeah.
Okay. Do we know this person? This third option is assuming that we might know this person.
I think we might have met him. He's probably like a side quest character.
Stormblood is like so long ago, and if it's a side quest, then I mean,
oh, he's the Ritz. Oh, okay, yeah.
He's the Redskin role. I don't get it. Yes, you know him.
Yeah, he's involved in some side quests.
He's from the Blue Mage side quest?
Hmm?
Oh, he's from the Blue Mage quest. No, he's in the Blue Mage quest. From the Blue Mage quest. He's in the Blue Mage quest. It's been a while since the Blue Mage quest. I need some more reminding. Do you know who this person is, Eclaria?
He's probably involved in some other, like... Bro, he's everywhere, isn't he? Okay, he's in level 70 Blue Mage, level 65 Blue Mage, level 63 Blue Mage.
He's also involved in Hildebrand's Stormblood quest. Oh, is it that guy? I think I might know who you're talking about now, Kaz. I think I might actually have an idea about who this might be, actually. That's the one? Okay.
And then I've only met him for the Stormblood, like, Hildebrand.
Yeah.
Because of the cast,
so,
the dungeon unlock.
So will we go with the third option?
Yeah.
Let's go. Oh, you've had dealings with him, have you? A couple. If you know, then you know. Ishun, on the other hand, is still something of an enigma. A skilled schemer. Steamer?
Simster.
Dedicated to his craft, thank you. Yes, he partnered with Kageyama I never would have guessed he had it in him. I mean, who wouldn't want to partner with Kageyama?
Kageyama would either throw a volleyball at you or toss to you. Either or.
There is more to this than meets the eye. We must investigate further. Have you any ideas where Ishun may have gone? At the fucking sound effects. The Namazu. Squeak, squeak.
The feet.
Anyway. You want information? Yes, yes. I want coin. Give me coin, and I will give you information.
Oh, dear.
Fair trade?
There can be a range if you're willing to journey to Raisen Temple. Our friend Furi can escort you.
A temple? And the one I've never heard of that... Wait! Is it the sort of place where mortals fear to tread? Malevolent spirits do dwell?
A fucking grimace.
Malevolent spirits. No, just somewhat ominous crystals. I'll take word of it for it. As for Ishun, he came to me and requested passage to Isla Beko, where he was rendezvous with Kageyama. I refused, better to not involve myself in the Baron's affairs, you understand. Kyoto, was it? Sorry.
I forgot
you were Shizaku.
Yeah, well, thanks. We shall fulfill our end of the bargain. You need not fear.
Look at him dance.
Just bring Liz over. Everything will be fine.
You know, I kind of wish their bell rang when they walked, but
it would get annoying.
The feet is cuter.
Yeah.
Squeak.
There is no need to waste. There is no time to waste. I shall have a messenger instruct Byakko and Saraban to meet us at the aisle.
Hiya, Clara.
She's an aura. She's an aura underneath you. I just knew it.
Right. Shall we just fly there? Whee! I'm gonna go to the teleport crystal, meet you in the Ruby Sea.
Okay, fine.
I'll fly you there. I'm a bird.
Let me jump!
You have to be specific.
Off the rails.
Mm-hmm.
Of this building. There is one floor above. Very safe.
Okay. Oh, look at we're gonna pass the island I dropped Alps on.
Oh. Harrier Isle?
This isle, yeah. I dropped him here and just kind of flew off and he couldn't jump off.
Oh, no.
I love islands that have invisible walls. I mean, maybe what I should do next time is fly him to a mark and just drop him in front of it. Look, we found a hunch mark.
I mean, that's a B rank though, so it won't attack.
I know, but like, if I fly him to a red mark and just drop him there and then fly off.
Ooh, Huang Niao. It's so Chinese, I can't.
Dudes, we're outside. The chicken and bunny outfit is no longer necessary. Please.
Bro, stop, please. Chu and Kageyama will want to keep away from prying eyes. Somewhere near these rocks, perhaps. Let us take cover and eavesdrop on their conversation when they join us.
Are the outfits necessary, please?
Yeah, they're not going to take you seriously.
Oh my god.
That's Kageyama. This bitch.
I was thinking this is Kageyama. Okay. Kageyama really went...
The stress dealing with Hinata must have lost.
I forget. I think I was Kageyama. A fine day's work, Ishin. It pays to have fools for customers.
Master Kageyama, please, this cannot continue. I shudder to think how the Fallouts will react if they learn of our crimes.
Oh, he knows. Remind me, who was it who delivered you from life of what?
Destitution.
Destitution after you lost your job as a
Simster.
Simster. Pray tell, who?
You, Master Kageyama. And I am forever grateful for your help, without which my family would be without house and home. But even so, what we are doing is wrong.
So it's his scheme. It's Kageyama's scheme, not this guy's scheme. Want to wash your hands? You want to wash your hands of this dirty, dirty business? Why, and be a again? Is that it? But once the truth comes out, and I would see that it does, who would dare trust you? No, Ishun, you're going to continue the act, or you and your kin will starve in the streets. Suzaku, you know you can burn him, right? And I don't like to see... I wouldn't like to see Kageyama burn, but this Kageyama is a douche.
Mm-hmm.
That's the way of it. Ishin was... courted by Kageyama. Forced into this performance, and for his family's sake, could not stop.
Indeed. In light of this, how shall we proceed? Burn.
We put the fear of the kami into Kageyama. I mean, both of these are the same answer, right?
Mm-hmm.
First one?
Yeah, first one.
Can we not do it with the outfits not on? Me. Guys, come on, please.
Please.
Who are you? And why are you dressed in such a ridiculous outfits? Oh. I know. Oh boy!
Why?
Why?
Hearken to me, mortal. I will suffer you to sully Senzan's name no longer. Defy me and you shall not like the consequences. How about you go back to being your bird form first, before saying things like this?
Sully Tenzin's name, say, you say? His flesh and blood are free to do with it as they please. Unless you can prove that Ishin is not in fact his descendant. I suggest you get out of my sight.
Then prove it we shall.
Oh boy.
Saruman!
Why are you in a bunny outfit still?
Not that fucking squirrel.
Oh! Here, Amber. Eclaria. Oh, hey! Now look, it's my sword.
It's my sword that I never carry around.
Well, Tenzin was a warrior of light, so technically it is our sword. Technically.
Yeah. Technically,
it is time we reveal our true selves, finally, thank God, to these mortals.
Do we get to fight, please? Do we get to burn him?
Please. Kami for Fend!
It cannot be.
Oh yeah, boy!
That flame-kissed katana you hold in your hand, is that the Phoenix Blade?
For the crimes you have wrought in Tenzin's name, your punishment shall be severe indeed. Beg not for mercy.
Take heart, my dears. I shall make your death painless. Hop into my room.
There is no turning back. Still, oh god, it auto-scrolled, an auto-text!
Heal yourself.
Yeah!
Is what it says.
Somebody help! Anybody help me!
Right.
Lol. What was that? Oh, hey, it's playing the good music. I like this theme. Not only do you possess the Phoenix Blade, but the four lords themselves stand at your side. Tell me, are you Tenzin's descendant? Yes, technically. Praise! Have mercy, I beg of you! I vow I will never use your name again of your ancestor! You have my word! Bye!
Why is our warrior of light samurai never this cool?
Oh boy. Hiya, Claria.
Well, hello.
I was inside you there for a second. That happens when we do the exact same quest.
Yeah.
Right, let's finish it up, shall we?
Yeah.
At Tenzin's behest, I once played the role of a fearsome tiger to frighten the people of a village and drive them to flee before they were buried in a landslide. He took part in the deception as well, but to be honest, your acting put his to shame.
Damn.
Have you considered us? Have you considered auditioning at the Manzaki
Mojikoza
Musicata Theater?
Man, even in death, he can't escape the rules thing.
Hmm.
Honored lords and ladies, and descendant of Tenzin, I know not how to make amends of my sins. Though action speaks louder than words, I wish to say that I'm truly sorry.
Man or beast, you are... We all make mistakes.
I am told you are a master simster.
I might not go so far as to say master, but my skill I managed to put food on the table.
Then perhaps I shall have a word with an old friend.
That can wait, Soraban. We must escort this young man to a safer location. This is far enough. It is past time we returned home. We are once more in your debt.
It is because of you that this affair could be concluded before Tenzin's reputation suffered irreparable harm. Thank you, Ember and Eclaria.
You're welcome, Bird. So. Never take on that chicken outfit ever again.
And the two of you, no more bunnies, please.
No more bunnies. I will have nightmares.
I already have it.
Now that you are no longer bound to Kageyama, what will you do?
Well, I know I must take responsibility for my actions. I'll confess my crimes to the Sekisegumi. After I'm released from my imprisonment, I shall take up an honest trade once more, and not rest until I have repaid each and every victim of my deception. Ah yes, I've been meaning to tell you, but I will let Hancock explain when he arrives shortly. When the fuck did you phone him?
Blink pearls.
Yes, but like on the way walking to the beach, and then he just casually calling out his bestie.
Yeah. He link pearled ahead of time. If it took a while for us to walk from that beach all the way over there from to this beach.
That is true.
Dreadfully sorry to have kept you all waiting.
Oh, Kataru, hello.
Yes.
Because the devil are actually true.
They're actually true. I mean, he's no Kaz, but, you know.
Yeah. And the urchin... Oh, wait, that's you.
And the urchin girl came as well. It has been far too long.
You're looking green as ever, Soraban of the blue. And once again, Jambu, that's Tataru. Tataru. Though I'm sure I'll have to remind you next time, too.
Are you Ishin, the
seamster
Soraban spoke of? Yes? Seamster, like seamstress, but guy.
Doing a guy, yes.
Yeah, I get it now. I was having trouble saying it because it was such a weird word.
Yeah.
My dyslexic brain just was not putting two and two together. If it is gainful employment you seek, the East Erdnall Trading Company would be thrilled to hire one of your expertise to work at our dapper shop. The seamster in our service fell ill, and we've been looking for a replacement.
I have no words. I'm grateful, truly, but I cannot accept, for once I confess my crimes to the Sekisegumi, they will surely imprison me for a time.
Oh yes, the Sekigumi. Why can't it just be called the Shinsengumi? It literally is that.
It's literally the Shinsengumi, like, literally.
It's just called Sekigumi, which is weird.
Say.
Anyway, I had a chat with them not long ago. They are aware that the scheme was contrived by Kageyama, and that you two are one of his victims. You will be required to assist them in their investigation, of course, but needn't steel yourself for even a brief incarceration. Thank you.
I have no idea why I know these words.
It's
too much true crime.
Hancock, you have our thanks for calling Amber to our aid. Oh no, not at all. I am pleased to have been of service. See, he's just a good guy. See, he's good.
Casually.
He's a good boy.
Into reports.
I have not forgotten our arrangement, Amber and Eclaria. Have you decided upon a reward?
A date.
Oh yeah.
Thank you.
A date. Oh, how that warms the heart. A material to help restore a keepsake of a dear friend. I have just the thing. I won't spoil the surprise now. But do look forward to it.
I suppose we had better return to the city, but before that, we could have caught... You could have called upon me too, you know? It's not like I wasn't part of the whole saving the Ruby Sea from becoming consumed by roaring flame endeavor or anything. Ah yes, this music.
Oh ho ho ho! Forgive us, urchin girl. Tataru. We assumed you were busy, that... and you did struggle mighty... Mightily to help Amber restrain Soraban to one time. So there was some concern that you might prove a liability should it come to blows. Nevertheless, we will take your words to heart. Oh boy.
Oh dear.
Perhaps we should assume our guise and walk.
No.
No. No.
No.
Please, no. No, 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 no. It's fine.
No, no, no. Please. You can just walk like this, honestly. Like,
yes.
At this point, just come as is.
Come as you are. Sorry. perhaps we should assume our guises and walk amongst men more often. It was a refreshing change of pace on the whole. I would not be against it were we in a bit of a rush on this occasion, but with a longer visit, we might better appreciate men's curious ways.
I have no doubt we shall meet again. I but pray that the time comes sooner than later.
Mm-hmm.
You and me both.
Mm-hmm. Until that day, I'll be sure to stop by the temple later. Until that day, I guess.
Yeah.
I'm not stopping by the temple later.
No, that's a dungeon.
That's a.
I ain't gonna fight you.
I will consider that a promise. I'm guessing both options are the same.
Yeah. It really doesn't matter. I think the only ones that matter is the Ishtola.
I think the second option is if you're still doing the Four Lords questline. right?
No, you can't do this quest if you haven't finished the Four Lords.
Okay. Then I don't know why they'd ask you to stop by the
It's
the
just like later. For role playing reasons for you to like say what you want.
No. The look
I'm sorry, my character looked too pretty. I keep staring at her. I will show you the screenshots I have in between. She's too pretty, I can't.
Yeah. Please do. Now then, I say we resume Soraban's training upon our return to the temple.
Oh no! More wasabi? must be so soon. Rip.
You did well to apprise Hancock of Ishun's predicament. We may not make amends by putting his talents to good use and continue to provide him for his family.
Indeed, 'twas behavior befitting one destined to become the next Gamble.
The road ahead is long, but we doubt not that you are worthy. And so we want only to encourage you to reach your full potential.
If that is how you all feel, then I have little choice but to do my best.
Oh my god, we're still going.
Oh, this is a long one.
Yep. I'm waiting for you to spawn in. There we go.
Hello, Ishu.
I am getting very hungry.
Oh no. We'll finish this and you get your food.
Yes.
I can still hardly believe that Seki Segumi only wished to question me. Master and God must have a way with words. Speaking of which, I believe he and Mistress Tataru will be joining us shortly. Oh yes, very shortly indeed.
There's Tataru. And there's Hancock. I like this theme too. How do you say his name?
Ishu.
You will be pleased to know that I've just finished making arrangements for your immediate employment. May our prophet soar that you may give your family the life they deserve.
Master Hancock, I do not deserve such kindness. I will do my best to earn my keep. I want you to know that I intend to work hard to make up for the many mistakes that I've made. It is not much, but I have prepared a gift for you as an expression of my gratitude. A set of garments that I made before I was embroiled in Master Kageyama's scheme. The lords and ladies of Kugane once held my work in high regard, and I hope you will as well.
You get an outfit?
Yeah.
Nice. Can't wait to see it.
It's a very nice outfit.
I'm looking forward to seeing it. I'm guessing then you've seen it already.
It's literally everybody wear it.
I have issue with Ishun? Why?
Amber, you know the way you're saying Ishu's name is literally a place in Singapore.
Sorry.
It's literally a place. And that every time when you say it, I'm just like, the next time if ever, like when Amber comes down to Singapore, I will bring you to that place.
Okay.
That's so funny. No, it's hilarious. I just keep getting reminded, like that's where I used to grow up. So good. I didn't correct you for that one reason.
Okay. You will also find a little something from me included within. A well-deserved reward.
Anya, the Tatara is confused. Wait, what exactly did you give Amber and Nicolaria?
payment for introducing the Eastern Aeronautic Trading Company to prospective new clients. What else?
I can't say I'm surprised you would try to peddle goods to the Four Lords themselves, but do. Have you no shame? Have you no shame?
Fixes his glasses.
Regardless, now as good a time as any to inform Amber and Claire of the result of our deliberation. Said result being, we have agreed to an official partnership with the East Aldenot Trading Company, one which I will exploit for all its worth to make Tataru Taru's boutique a household name in Kugani.
For my part, I pray this is the start of a mutual beneficial partnership.
I believe in Tataru. To business. I will have a tour of this draper shop of yours immediately, if you don't mind. Sorry to cut things short, Amber and Clara, but time is money, and I have precious little to spare. Once you've seen to any other unresolved matters you have here, I'll be grateful if you return to Old Shalian and involve Mezina of our new arrangement.
Okay.
I'm just a messenger girl at this point.
Mm-hmm. We both are.
We just revert back to that again.
Yeah, I mean, no world needed after, saving. With the world no longer needing saving, the Warrior of Light goes back to being messenger and delivery person.
Well, original job, not an adventurer.
This the original job is delivery person. Like, if you started in Nulda, you delivered cookies to guards.
Yeah, cookies and drinks. Oh, yeah. No, yeah, cookies.
Just cookies.
Just to get, like, fucking answers.
Yes. Just to get answers. Yes. Right, to Charlea. I got it. You will accept the TP.
Yes. I shall. How many tickets do I even have left? Jesus. Mm-hmm. Fetch quest extraordinaire unironically, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we can just teleport everywhere.
Mm-hmm. We are the best. We are better than the post-Moogle themselves.
I literally graduated post-Moogery, okay?
Yeah, same! I got the hat.
Yeah, we unironically is better than any post-Moogle. Hold on, let me
I'm waiting for them to update that at some point. Alright, you ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Welcome back. Negotiations with Master Hancock were fruitful, I hope. Well, I expected nothing less from you and Mistress Tataru. As for Mistress Tataru's necklace, you say Master Hancock slipped a gift into the parcel you received from Ishun. Yes? May I have a look? Let's see what he do. My goodness, what a stunning set of garments. They certainly offer a taste of the Far East. As for the item Master Hancock set aside for Mistress Tataru's necklace. By the sisters, a black pearl. Ooh! Do you have any idea how rare these are? They can only be harvested from black-lipped oysters in the Ruby Sea. I can't be certain until it has been
incorporated
into the necklace, but I believe the darker shade shall serve as a contrast to the brilliant sapphire centerpiece and make it stand out even more. To part with such a precious treasure, Master Hancock is either very wealthy or very well connected. Or both. I'm thinking both. We would do well to maintain good relationship with the East Aeronaut Trading Company. Mm-hmm. But that's is the boutique's concern. After all you've done for us, I'm sure you want nothing more than to than a good rest. I want food. I need food.
Yeah, I was about to say food.
Food? Food. Thank you again for your continued assistance. When we next discover a client, we'd like you your aid in to our ever-growing list. I hope we can count on your assistance once more. Do 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 do. Okay. And that's it. Taru's endeavors done. Let's go to the cafe and sit while I go make food and you make...
I'll just go to the inn room to settle my inventory.
Yeah. If you want, you can sit your Lala next to me when you log in as your Lala.
Wait, I can't go to Charlie, remember.
Oh.
I'll be by the FC house.
Well, in that case, I'll go to the FC house and sit there.
Okay.
So that you can sit your Lala next to me. I forgot that you can't. I forgot that you can't come here. Okay. I forgot.
Yeah.
I forget.
Okay. I forgot.
It's okay. It's sorted. It's fine.
I'll just settle my inventory. I'll check on my retainer, and then I'll be back to my Lala.
I'm gonna be sitting here, drinking tea. Well, my character is. I'm going to make food. So.
Yeah, your baby sister still can't come to Charlie just yet. I'm planning on getting her to Charlie by.
All right, chat.
What?
I'll be right back. I'm gonna go make food.
And I'll be logging off here to get to my Lala.
Yes, but Eclaria will keep you company, chat. No worries. See you in a bit.
No topic. Oh, meeting is that Ember. What the fuck?
What the fuck, Ember?
Meeting's done, so I'm heading back to my Lelefell, my bebe, and then adding people to the group to go for near. I'm logging off. Fucking hell, Ember. I know you're laughing, I just know it. Oh dear. I have her patience. Time to run stuff with the la la.